Hey guys, it's Violet Myers. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today's video is gonna be something really cool, something new to the channel, something I've been really wanting to do for a long time, and it's talk about anime.
Don't fuck with me! I have the power of God and anime on my side!
I know a lot of people see me on Twitter talking about anime. I know I do sometimes on like Snapchat. When I'm with like my friends and family, I like to talk a lot about anime, and we just like to talk about what's coming out, like what's going on and stuff like that. So I thought I would bring it to my channel and kind of show you guys more of myself on here. So if you're new to my channel, make sure you're subscribed, give this video a thumbs up, have your post notifications on so you guys are aware when I'm uploading and when I have a new video coming out. I'm gonna be showing you guys my opinions and like shows that I'm looking forward to this year. I have so many shows I'm gonna be watching this year. I don't even know how I'm gonna balance everything, but I somehow always make it work. On top of that, I'm also reading a bunch of manga. If you guys want a manga review, or if you guys want to see my manga collection, comment down, give this video a thumbs up so I know you guys want to see that type of content, if you guys want to see more anime content on my channel. So let's get straight into the video. I have a long list of anime, so let's get started. So I have a huge list here of animes for the year. it looks short, but it's pretty long. So
pause.
I have it down to categories. We're gonna start with isekais. So if you're new to anime, isekai is basically like a fantasy world. It's like a human person transitioning to another universe, stuff like that. Sword Art Online, Rising of the Shield Hero, those are a few. ReZero Season 2 Part 2. They took a break, but it's gonna continue this year, so I'm excited. I only watched the first season. I didn't really start the second season, but I hear amazing things about the second season, and I'm looking forward to finishing the conclusion to this season. So that's what I'm definitely looking out for isekais. That's pretty much the only one, unless Konosuba comes back, but there's like no dates or anything. But Konosuba just came out with the dubbed of the movie, so I'm definitely gonna watch that because I love the movie. The movie's so freaking hilarious. Kazuma is one of my favorite anime boys, so if you know, you know. I feel like only the cultured know. Let's go to drama and romance. So one of the first ones I'm gonna start is To Your Eternity. I forgot which creator was it that announced this. I don't know. I'm gonna post a little clip right here of like what it's supposed to be about. I saw the trailer and I was like, I added that to my list. So another one I'm gonna be checking out, it's a slice of life romantic comedy. It's called Horimiya, if I'm mispronouncing it. I'm sorry. But basically it's like a romantic comedy where the two main characters have these hidden sides about one another. I don't know what they are yet, but it is a manga adaptation. But one character has socializing issues and is shy, while the other one is like an otaku but has like a bunch of tattoos and piercings. So basically like opposites attract. Two different types of like people attract each other and they somehow try to make it work. So that's basically what the anime is about. It is a manga adaptation. I'm definitely checking that out. I love a romantic comedy. That's like, it's one of my favorite things about anime. I don't like romantic comedy movies, but I definitely like animes because I can relate. So we're gonna go to fantasy and thriller. I feel like this is the most anticipated anime for the year, one of them. And it's The Promised Neverland Season 2. I actually read the manga because I was like, there's no way, like I knew there was gonna be like a second part to them after, spoiler, after they escaped basically from that hell. I know a lot of people on TikTok are simping over the demons. I'm not gonna lie, I am too. But there's like a lot of demons and then they're basically just trying to make it to the outside world to like, you know, survive and have a better life outside of the orphanage. So that's one of my most hyped seasons I'm looking forward to because I read the manga and honestly the manga is so sad and there's a lot of stuff going on. So I'm looking forward to seeing it being animated, but I'm also kind of sad too because I think there's only gonna be 12 episodes, I think. So I don't know how they're gonna fit all of the manga into the show. I saw that there was a movie. I don't know when that's coming out either. But let's hope that there's like at least a part two because there's so much going on. But even if there isn't, at least I have the manga, you know what I mean? Beastars is coming back. So excited. It's not like, I know a lot of people on Twitter were talking about how Beastars is basically like furry and like hentai, but if you actually watch the show, it's a lot of action and a lot of basically a lot of drama. I really love the animation. I love the opening. That's one of the shows I'm looking forward to. Also, the time I got reincarnated by a slime, season 2.
My friend.
I need to finish the first season, but it's like a really short anime. I can honestly finish that in 2 days. But I'm looking forward to the second season because I really like the anime and the characters are pretty cool. Now we're gonna go to action and shonen. I've been trying to freaking get a hard copy because I hate reading manga on my phone. Like, my eyes hurt. I even have like glasses for blue light, but I don't like reading manga online. So I've been trying to get this manga, Chainsaw Man. I feel like everyone that's like knows about Chainsaw Man knows how freaking good it is and is so excited for the anime. Check it out. Like, I'll post like a picture or a clip of what the characters look like. I'm definitely like so hyped to check out Chainsaw Man. Another one is Demon Slayer. Demon Slayer is coming back. I know I want anime of the decade. I have no comment about that, but I do love Demon Slayer. It's a great anime. I mean, it's beautiful, so I'm looking forward to the movie and watching the second season. Also, Jujutsu Kaisen's coming back. I'm looking forward to that too. I just caught up, so excited. It ended like not in a cliffhanger, but kind of like giving you an idea of what's gonna happen. I haven't read the manga, so I don't know what's gonna happen. I honestly didn't like the manga. I read the first book, but I didn't like it.
Shit, boy.
Maybe if I read on from like where the second part, maybe I'll get into it. I'll check out the manga. I don't know if this is true or not, if this was rumor, but I heard One Punch Man's coming back. I don't know if that's true or not. I don't know. Don't fight me. But I did see something on YouTube about how One Punch Man season 3 is gonna come out. So I'm looking forward to that. I love the creator of One Punch Man because it has one of my favorite animes, Mob Psycho, which I'm currently reading. Did you guys know that? I didn't know, but let me show you guys. I guess I don't have it. They added a new character to Mob Psycho, and this guy doesn't have, I think he's like at 130 something or something like that, but I'm so excited to read that. Seven Deadly Sins, they're on the fourth or fifth season, I'm not sure, but I'm excited because I just love Seven Deadly Sins. I don't get the hate. I get it. People have their things or what they like and don't like, but I personally like Seven Deadly Sins and I'm looking forward to the season. I watched the Netflix one, the one they have it on Netflix, not the, like, I guess, I don't know, but I thought the animation was good. Maybe they changed the studios, but either way, it wasn't like, I didn't get any of the memes or like the animation. I thought it was pretty good. I love the storyline. I'm looking forward to the new Seven Deadly Sins. Apparently there's gonna be another Mob Psycho. I'm not sure. Like I said, these are just rumors. Correct me in the comments or something, but Mob Psycho is like one of my top 5 favorite animes. So I'm looking forward to watching the new Mob Psycho. Vinland Saga season 2. Stop sleeping on Vinland Saga. I don't know, I guess Demon Slayer and Vinland Saga were one of the best animes for 2018, 2019, but I don't know. The last season of Haikyuu, I only watched like 7 episodes of Haikyuu, but I really actually fell for the show and I actually really think it, I don't really like sports, but I actually really like the characters. The show's pretty funny, so I'm looking forward to the last season so I can catch up because I want to know the hype. I want to get the memes, you know, the whole, sometimes I feel like I'm like missing out on so many shows because I'm watching other shows, but definitely Haikyuu, the fan base is strong. I'm looking forward to catching up and watching the last season of Haikyuu. The Stone Wars. When I tell you guys, if you think Dr. Stone is boring, you need to watch it. Yeah, or you probably are one of those people that didn't like school, because like Dr. Stone will definitely prepare you for like the end of the world, and Senku is like one of my favorite protagonists. So Dr. Stone, Stone Wars, this is gonna be so hype. I'm looking forward to seeing how this war is gonna play out, and like the characters in the beginning of the show, they're coming back, and I'm so excited to see them. Like, I just love Dr. Stone. Rising of the Shield Hero season 2. Like I said, a lot of reoccurring shows, but I'm so hyped to watch the Rising of the Shield Hero. I love it. It's only like 13, 12 episodes, so catch up, you guys. A lot of these shows, they only have a little bit of episodes, so you definitely can catch up and watch these and see the hype and why they're my favorites. Another one is My Hero Season 5.
Oh yeah! Oh yeah! Oh yeah!
You gonna make me act up.
I don't like the fan base.
Whoa, 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 hey, 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 hey!
But I do love My Hero, so I'm looking forward to the fifth season. I love it, love it, love it. And the fourth season was amazing. It's only gonna get better. And like, manga readers, don't spoil it in the comments, but there's a lot of action gonna go down. That's all I know. Okay, this one's another rumor too. I don't know if it's true or not, but Code Geass is gonna come back, but it's gonna be a spinoff. I don't know if Lelouch is gonna come back for this one, but I think there's gonna be new characters and stuff, but either way, it's Code Geass. I'm looking forward to it. This one's, I think, of Shaman King. I think this one is a remake. I'm looking forward to seeing it because a lot of people are looking forward to it, and I don't want to sleep on this one, so I'm definitely gonna be checking out Shaman King. It's another shonen. Check out the trailer, like I said. That's one I'm definitely gonna be watching for sure. And this one's a new one. This one's called Record of Ragnarok. I think that's how you pronounce it. I don't know, but it's a new anime that's coming out. I'm looking forward to it. The characters look so cool. I'm looking at the pictures right now. See me simping over a few of these people. Yes, I'm one of those people who simps over characters. So yeah, it looks pretty cool. So that's it for my action and shonen. I'm gonna go to Slice of Life, which is my personal favorite category. I love me some action, but honestly, sometimes a lot of action can be overwhelming, like Baki. So I need a good slice of life. Slice of Life is definitely my top two favorite anime categories. So the first one is skates. I'm so looking forward to watching this skate anime. I used to watch like a bunch of skating videos growing up, so this is gonna be really cool to see like an anime adaptation of a skate. I haven't seen anything like that, so I'm looking forward to that. Miss Kobayashi season 2. Miss Kobayashi is like one of my top 5 favorite animes. Which I need to do like a list so you guys can kind of see my top favorite animes. But either way, Miss Kobayashi, I read the manga. Looking forward to meeting new characters. And then, I don't know, I'm just a huge Kana like simp. Not the simp that you guys think, but the simp where it's like, I freaking adore her. I even have her like side stories. Like, she's one of my favorite anime characters because she's just so cute. Another one is Uzaki-chan. This one got so much hate last year. Like, it was crazy. Like, if you know, you know. Nux even did a video about it. Shout out to Nux. I love you. I love your channel. I love her. She's so cute. And she like has like a bubbly personality. I love the way she says senpai.
Senpai. Senpai. Senpai. Senpai. Senpai.
Senpai!
Senpai!
Like, it's so cute. And then Rent-A-Girlfriend season 2. Can we talk about that cliffhanger? Jesus, like, why is it so hard to express? Why is it so hard for people to express how they feel? Like, he's, I don't know, whichever girl he chooses, I'm gonna go for. Like, I'm okay, but Ruka, I stan Ruka, that's my girl. And then the last one is The Quintessential Quintuplets season 2. Looking forward to watching the second season as well. And the last anime I would say I'm looking forward to the most, because I've read this book twice, okay? And this book is thick as fuck. Like, it's so thick.
Pause.
I can't, and like, it's going on Toonami too. It's gonna be an anime adaptation, and they're doing, I watch the trailer, you guys. If you read the manga, then I feel like just watching the trailer, they did the book justice. Junji Ito is one of my favorite horror manga. I have a few of his books here. Like I said, Uzumaki. I love horror. Myers, that's why it's my last name. But yeah, I'm so excited for this year's anime. I don't really watch a lot of television. I either watch anime or YouTube. It's either or. And this year literally freaking killed it. After last year's BS, you know, last year we had some really great animes, don't get me wrong, but this year is the year. I don't even know what else. They still have a bunch of announcements. Like I said, I have a few rumored ones. I'm looking forward to watching a bunch of anime and not doing anything and skipping my responsibilities just to watch a bunch of TV. Definitely be on the lookout. Hopefully I can do reaction channels so we can all watch them together, because I know a lot of people want to watch anime with me. but I don't know how to. I'm still figuring out this YouTube stuff. Oh, I also heard one more thing, because I have like a poster, but I heard also High School DxD is gonna come back. I'm not sure about that, correct me if I'm wrong, but I heard a rumor that High School DxD is probably gonna come back. It's just the year of waifus, honestly, again, like I said. So yeah, this is gonna be an amazing year to anime, for us anime fans. And you know, I gave some of you guys a good list of anime's recommendations, basically, you know, for second seasons, reoccurring, and new shows, because I know a lot of people ask me, Violet, give me some recommendations. Here you go. Here are your recommendations. Here's what I'm watching. But also, if you're going to ask me for recommendations, make sure you tell me what kind of category you want, or how long. Do you want to watch it very shortly? Do you want to, like, you guys need to be specific. I'm not going to suggest you a good, like, a show. Like, let's say you want to watch Assassination Classroom, but you really want to watch like a harem. Make sure you guys are specific. But yeah, I'm going to sign off. I'm finished with the video. Make sure you guys are subscribed to the channel. Comment down below what shows you guys are looking forward to. I do interact with you guys. Let me know what you guys are looking forward to. Correct me if I'm wrong. Like I said, rumors down below. I definitely want to interact with you guys. I want to talk more anime. Bringing it more to the channel. 2021 and here on out. I'm doing nothing but YouTube. Like I said, I'm still trying to figure out a schedule. But yeah, thank you guys. I love you guys. Have a great year.